Hey guys, it's Jessica from Peace Love Books, and today I'm here with a video that is actually a collaboration with Tamika. We are doing romances that we can read in one day, or that we did read in one day. These are romances that we just flew through, either in one day or over a few days, if like we would have finished in one day if we didn't. Things that you'll probably fly through too. I have a mix of historical and contemporary romances, and one kind of dystopian romance that I'm excited to talk about. And so make sure you check out Tamika's video. I will link it down below. When she asked me if I wanted to collaborate, I was like, of course. I'm very excited. I love Tamika's channel. She reads a lot more indie romances than I do. She does dabble in the dark romance more so than I do, and a lot of different subgenres of indie romances, so check her out if you haven't yet. But I will go ahead and get to some romances that I binged pretty much in one day, but I think you would read very quickly as well. The first one is actually young adult, and I'm gonna get that out of the way because I recently read this in the beginning of January, and it was more because I was on winter break from school. I'm a teacher, and I devoured this in one day, and that is Happily Ever Afters by Elise Bryant. This is young adult, but it is so good, and it definitely reads more young adult because our main character does make decisions that teenagers make, and I really appreciate that about this book. But our main character, she is a writer, and her mother secretly entered her into a writing school, like performing arts school, where all these different people have their different like things that they're into. And so she'd be in the writing program, and she got in, but she's never shared her writing with anyone aside from her best friend, and she's a romance writer. As soon as she starts at school though, she has this like imposter syndrome where she's like, there's no way I can be in here, there's no way my writing's good enough, and she gets writer's block for weeks. And so her friend is like, well, why don't you have a romance yourself and get that mojo back? And so she sets her eyes on like the golden boy at school, but the romance is actually between the neighbor of hers, and the author's actually said this when she says, it's not a spoiler, it is between her and the boy who lives across the street, Sam, and it's adorable. And our main character goes through a lot, makes some not good decisions. It's kind of a love triangle, but I loved it, and I read it in one day, and I think you would devour it as well. There are a couple of historical romances on here. So one of them is On the Way to the Wedding by Julia Quinn. This is actually the last Bridgerton book, and I read this in like a day and a half. I was flying through it because Gregory's book is just so much fun. Gregory has watched all of his siblings fall in love, and he is like, I want love. So he's the opposite of pretty much every single one of his brothers, because all of his brothers are annoying when it comes to romance, and he's like, I want a woman. And so he sees this woman, Hermione, and he's like, she is the one. I want her. But Hermione's actually in love with someone else, and Lucinda's Hermione's best friend, and she doesn't like who Hermione's in love with. He's like below her station, and she's like, Hermione would never be able to marry someone that's below her. And so she agrees to help Gregory win over Hermione, and in the process, Gregory and Lucy end up falling for each other, and it's adorable, and I just couldn't put this down. It was so much fun. It's actually in my top half, I think. I don't remember if this is like 4 or 5 out of all of them. I really love this series. I didn't give any less than 4 stars, but this one got a 5 star. I could not put it down. I just love a hero in love, and it was so much fun. And we get like a scene in the beginning where Gregory's trying to break up a wedding. Oh yeah, we have this pretty set back too. And then we flash back, and we don't know whose wedding it was, what's gonna happen, so it was really great. Then we have Let Me Please You by Alexandria House. I listened to this in about one or two days. I listened to the audiobook, and it is a novella, but it is a bodyguard romance, and I have not read the series. I went back and read book one after reading this one. I think it's either 3.5 or 4.5, but it's a bodyguard romance, and the heroine takes care of her sibling's child a lot, so her nephew, I think it was a boy, I don't remember the gender of the child, but she watches them a lot. But she has famous siblings, and so one of her siblings is a famous musician, and so they have bodyguards, and they have a bodyguard for her, and they end up falling for each other, and they really don't want to, especially the bodyguard. He's been working for the family for a long time, and he doesn't want to like betray the trust he's built with his boss, and he doesn't want to lose his job, but he's fallen for her. So if you like a bodyguard romance, I'd recommend this. It is a novella, so it's pretty short and very quick to get through. The audiobook was great, so I definitely recommend that. I do have 2 other novellas, and the first one's Maiden the Huntress by Talia Hibbert. This one I flew through because it's a novella. It is actually paranormal, and it is hate to love. She literally tries to kill the hero because she's from a family of werewolf hunters. Like, they're hunters, but she has a prophecy where, like, she'll kill the one she loves, or, like, rip their heart out or something. I don't remember. And so she hasn't been allowed to, like, be a hunter, but then she's a barista, I think, and a werewolf comes into her shop, and it's like Fated Mates. He's like, that's my mate. I want her. And he's nothing like what she thought werewolves were. Her families think they're all these like brutal killers. And he's just like a normal guy who just happens to be a werewolf. And so she kind of wants to let him get close to her so she can kill him and prove that she can be a hunter. And it's great. Or a huntress. It's a great romance. It's really fun. If you like a just fun paranormal, I would definitely recommend this. I flew through it, like I said. It's pretty short. You can get through it definitely in one day. Another book I got through in one day was actually because this was a book club pick for Ravished by Romance, the book club I run with Lacey from Lacey Book Lovers, and I didn't start it until the day of the live show, so I had to read it in one day. But that's An Extraordinary Union by Alyssa Cole. I flew through this book, and it wasn't like I hated it and like had to drag myself through it to get through it to the live show. I was loving this book and I gave it 5 stars. Even though I forced myself to read it in one day, I loved every second of it. It is a Civil War romance with spies, and our heroine is a free black woman, but then she decides to pose as a slave in the South for a family to try to uncover secrets. And then the hero is also posing with the family trying to court their daughter, and the heroine and the hero, who are spies, fall for each other. But it's sad because they can't act like they even like each other in public, because he's supposed to be like way higher than her and she's supposed to be the slave who should be stupid and not know anything, and she's actually really intelligent and they say really bad things to her and she can't say anything because she's posing as a slave and she's really a spy. But it's so good, and there were some crazy things that happened at the end, and it's not too long. It's 250 pages, so I flew through this. I'm excited to read more in this series. Then we have one that I think a lot of you have already read, but that is Your Dad Will Do by Katie Robert. This one I read very quickly. It's really short. It is a romance between a woman and her fiance's, ex-fiance's, ex-boyfriend's. I think it was her ex-fiance. I don't remember if they were engaged or not, but it is her ex's dad. And kind of in retaliation, she decides to get together with him. Not a lot of plot to this. It's mostly just steam, but it was a lot of fun. If you like that kind of romance and you want something just quick that you can fly through, Your Dad Will Do is perfect. Then an audiobook I flew through was Fire in His Blood by Ruby Dixon. So I flew through the Ice Planet Barbarian series, but I feel like everybody's read that already. If you haven't, go check it out. It's amazing alien romances, and I fly through those audiobooks as well. But this one is post-apocalyptic with dragons, and they're dragon shifters, and I remember all of them are like mixing together, but I think in this one, because two of them, they like sacrifice the woman, they like the scents of women, and so they'll like sacrifice women to like draw the dragons in so they can kill the dragons. But I think she was like put out as a sacrifice because I think she was caught stealing and like had to go to jail, and then they were gonna put her as a sacrifice. But then she ends up getting taken by the dragon and mating with the dragon, and the dragons, things are happening with them where they are like going insane and they don't have a grasp on reality, but like the women who are their mates like help ground them. So it's really good. I really love the first one. Book 2, I think I really enjoyed. Unless it was book 3. I don't remember. There was one I really liked where like the dragon got captured and she had to go and save him. That one was really good. I think that's book 3 actually. I haven't continued on, so I don't know everything that's happening with the dragons, but the series is great and you can definitely fly through it. You can fly through any Ruby Dixon books really, but I really liked it. And the last one I have is a romance booktube favorite, but I flew through this as well, and that is Desperate Measures by Katie Robert. I haven't finished the rest of the series yet, but they are really dark and steamy takes on Disney. I don't really know how else to describe it. So this one is Jafar and Jasmine. So like they're the Disney villains with the Disney heroines normally, and like the heroes from the Disney stories are normally the bad guys. So in this one, it's Jafar and Jasmine, and it is age gap, and there's like consent, non-consent. So like they like to act like she's not consenting, but like she really is consenting, or she verbally doesn't consent, but she is physically, kind of thing. So this one kind of blurs those lines, but it's a lot of fun and it goes by very quickly. And these are just so unique. I haven't read anything like this series before. Well, at least the first book, and I'm really excited to continue on with them because we have Hades and Meg and Tink and Hook, and I think it goes on. It definitely goes on from there because there's a few more. Like I think the Beast is one of them, but I don't remember who that's with. So yeah, these are really good though, and I would recommend them if you want something really quick. They're pretty short too, so they are just over 200 pages, so you can definitely fly through it in a day. And those are some romances that I think you can fly through in one day, or I actually read in one day. Let me know down below if you have any authors that are your go-to to fly through, or any books that you read really quickly. I would love to hear. Make sure you check out Tamika's video. I cannot wait to see her recs and read some from her video. But that's all I have. As always, thank you so much for watching, and have a good day. Bye.